Welcome to this feature presentation about how to configure a SoftGRE tunnel between an RGNet's rXg and a Ruckus access point controlled by a virtual SmartZone. Before we dive into the specifics of the configuration of SoftGRE, let's start with what a SoftGRE tunnel is. SoftGRE is a transport of a layer 2 frame over a layer 3 frame. Specifically, a layer 2 frame from a wireless station gets an IP and GRE header prepended to them, and the rXg de-encapsulates this data. It also works for VLAN tagged frames. The use case for SoftGRE is when you do not want to extend all of your VLANs to the Ethernet port the access point is connected to, for security reasons, for example. Another use is when your layer 2 network doesn't extend to where your access point is. An example of this is a remote branch office with access points that have WANs associated with VLANs that only exist at the main office. SoftGRE will tunnel the data from the branch office over a layer 3 network to the main office's rXg. Some caveats to be aware of. Not all firewall vendors NAT GRE. Also, there's no security or encryption with SoftGRE. So the use of an underlying method to protect the transported data, such as a private network or IPsec VPNs, are recommended. Okay, now on to the fun part, the configuration of SoftGRE. There are two items which need to be configured, the rXg and the Ruckus Virtual Smart Zone. Let's get started with the configuration of the rXg. Log into your rXg. Select Network and LAN. Let's go over the configuration of this particular rXg for this demo. This rXg has four physical interfaces, VMX0 through VMX3. VMX3 has 10 VLANs defined, VLAN 100 through 109. The uplink or WAN port has the IP address of 192.168.200.104. This connects to the internet. VMX3 has the IP address of 192.168.5.1/24. And the 10 VLANs on VMX3 have the IP addresses of 10.0.100.1/24 through 10.0.109.1/24. When creating a SoftGRE interface, it's important to note that by default, traffic is not allowed to connect to the rXg SoftGRE listen interface. This is for security reasons. There are two ways to allow access point and other SoftGRE endpoints to connect to the rXg. The first is through a policy. Policies are for devices downstream of the rXg, and some are created automatically when you create a wireless or a switch infrastructure device, and some you can create manually. Another way to whitelist traffic to the rXg is to use what's called a WAN target, where you can specify the IP address of the device you wish to connect. Let's start with how to create a WAN target whitelist. Select Identity and Definition. Under WAN targets, select Create New, give the WAN target a name, add your IP address you wish to whitelist, and select Create. You can see in the WAN target list, AP1 is now listed. To create a policy for a device that could be downstream on the rXg, select Policies. Select Create New, give your policy a name. We'll call this AP Ruckus 1. And select Create. Now we need to associate an IP address with Ruckus AP 1. Under IP groups, select the hyphen. Select Create New. We'll call this AP Ruckus 1 AP IP group. And we'll add the IP address of 192.168.5.100. Oh, that IP address should go here. And then select Create. So now we have a policy for AP Ruckus 1 that's associated with the downstream IP address of 192.168.5.100. Let's go back to network and LAN. Under sudo interfaces, select create new. Under interface type, select SoftGRE. Let's give our SoftGRE tunnel a name. The member interfaces listed right here are the interfaces that are bridged to the SoftGRE interface and are not tagged with any data. In this example, we will use VMX3, which is associated with the 192.168.5.0 management network. In the VLAN section here, these are the VLANs that are associated with the SoftGRE tunnel and also are tagged on the SoftGRE tunnel going to the remote access points. Down here under the SoftGRE listen interface, this is where you associate the policies and the WAN targets to whitelist traffic in from downstream devices represented by policies. In this case, we will use AP Ruckus 1, which we just created. We will also say we have AP on the upstream or WAN interface or internet, and we want to allow that to connect too. Under WAN targets, we will select the access point that we created a couple moments ago, AP1. This is a recommended MSS. However, if you need to create smaller TCP packets to prevent fragmentation, you can change this MSS value here. And we click Create. That is all it takes to create a SoftGRE tunnel on the rXg. There's no need to define endpoints for mapping MAC addresses to remote access points because traffic into SoftGRE is originated at the access point, and the rXg creates a map to understand how to route data back to endpoints. Next step is configuring the Ruckus virtual smart zone. In this step, we will need to create a tunnel that tells the virtual smart zone how to contact the rXg we just enabled SoftGRE on. Under services and profiles, scroll down to tunnels and ports, select SoftGRE, and select create. Add a name for your SoftGRE tunnel and add an IP address for the access point to send SoftGRE packets to the rXg. In this example, 192.168.200.104 is the IP address of the VMX0 interface on the rXg, which we whitelisted our SoftGRE configuration. Finally, click OK. Under wireless LANs, in the zone which you wish to configure SoftGRE on, click Edit for the zone, and this is not an so obvious step. You have to scroll down and associate the SoftGRE profile with the zone. Under the APGRE tunnel option, this does not appear to be a selectable button. However, it is. Click Select, and the newly created SoftGRE profile that we just created in the previous step is now listed. Click on the arrow button and add it to the selected profiles and click OK. Now you will see that under the SoftGRE profiles, the newly created rXg04 is now listed to be in the zone. Click OK to complete the editing of the zone. Now we will create a wireless LAN on the SoftGRE zone using the SoftGRE tunnel. Click Create under Wireless LANs. Let's give this a very creative name. With the SoftGRE name and the SoftGRE SSID, we will make this very simple and have an open SSID. Under Data Plane Options, under Access Networks, toggle the button. The GRE profile will be rXg04. If you do not see your GRE tunnel profile listed here, it means you have not added it to the zone, so go back to the previous step that I discussed. Click OK, and that is the end of the configuration needed on the Ruckus virtual smart zone. Now we will attempt to connect to the SoftGRE wireless network we just created. We see it listed in our wireless network list, so the SSID of this newly created wireless network is being broadcasted. We have connected to this network and we have received a valid IP address and internet access is confirmed. Using ipconfig, we will see that we have received a valid IP address from the rXg of 192.168.5.10, which is the encapsulated untag data from the VMX3 interface, which is configured on the rXg. To confirm network access, we will ping the default gateway of the rXg and also some internet addresses, the level 3 DNS server 4.2.2.1. And to make sure DNS works, we will also ping www.google.com. This concludes a SoftGRE feature introduction on the RGNet's rXg and how to configure it with Ruckus wireless access points. All of the features you would expect out of a traditional VLAN tagged wire connected to the access point still work, such as dynamic VLAN assignment. These VLANs are just transported over the SoftGRE tunnel instead of the tagged locally directed wire. Keep following us for more upcoming features.